Hey there, folks, and welcome to Freeside. Well, not actually. We're really in the northern part of Las Vegas, just south of Fremont Street, and home to the Fremont Street Experience, or what many call Old Town. But to us Wastelanders, we know it as Freeside. It's a crazy place full of Vegas fun and wild nightlife. Not that I would know anything at all about that. No, sir. Not an upstanding scout like myself. Not at all. But what I do know is a thing or two about this iconic New Vegas location right over here. Fallout friends, I give you the birthplace of Las Vegas, the Old Mormon Fort. As you can see, this striking historical site is right smack dab in the middle of the Las Vegas urban sprawl, just as it appears in the game. It is located on the corners of Las Vegas and East Washington Boulevards. Let's check it out. Oh, wait, what's that, Coyote? No dogs allowed? Oh, well, shucks. Well, I guess you'll have to find some coyote stuff to do. Have fun!
Bright light city, gonna set my soul, gonna set my soul on fire. Got a whole lot of money that's ready to burn, so get those stakes up higher.
So here we are at the Old Mormon Fort Visitor Center, a beautiful museum and interpretive center where your discovery of the Old Mormon Fort and its amazing history begins. The parking entrance is on the right side off of East Washington Boulevard, just after you cross over Las Vegas Boulevard. The Visitor Center operates Tuesdays through Saturday and from the hours of 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. It's closed on Sundays and Mondays. As we just learned from Coyote, there's no pets allowed with the exception of service animals, who are always welcome. Once inside, you'll be greeted by friendly and helpful Nevada State Park rangers eager to answer your questions and help you begin your tour. The visitor center is filled with dynamic and informative displays and exhibits which provide an excellent understanding of the fort and its place in our history. Your journey truly starts once you step outside to the actual grounds of the Old Mormon Fort. You'll first discover a peaceful courtyard where you can find amenities such as picnic areas, restrooms, and drinking fountains. You'll immediately spot a set of stairs and the familiar fort just above. Informative state park interpreters are on site to guide you through the fort and answer any questions you may have. Hey, here's one now. Ladies and gentlemen, meet state park interpreter Sherri. She's going to tell us all about the Old Mormon Fort. So, Sherri, take it away.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Old Las Vegas Mormon Fort, the place where Las Vegas began and end, I guess, right? This is where Mormon missionaries built the fort, and that's why it's called the Old Las Vegas Mormon Fort. But the reason everybody came here is because of water. Water is the reason everybody came here. There's a creek that flowed through here and brought the Native Americans, brought the missionaries of the Mormons, and all the pioneers after that. And then the railroad bought this site and created Las Vegas.
The Old Mormon Fort was built as Mormons traveled westward, embracing the concept of manifest destiny, a massive continental westward expansion movement. The Mormons, who had previously settled in Salt Lake City under the leadership of Brigham Young, set up hundreds of camps and settlements all over the Southwest. In the mid-1800s, the Mormon Road, which followed part of the Old Spanish Trail, a main travel route between Los Angeles and Mexico, began moving toward California as Brigham Young's intention was to set up missions and to proselytize the native Paiute living in the region. When they arrived in the Las Vegas Valley, which means the meadows in Spanish, the Mormon missionaries immediately discovered the many springs providing excellent water. It became clear a settlement there would be ideal as it would provide a critical and strategic stop for people traveling to California to rest and gather supplies. Most importantly, safe drinking water. So Sherri, is the creek still running?
The creek runs, but this is an artificial creek now. The aquifers that fed the water dried up in the 1960s.
In 1855, Brigham Young chose 30 men to establish a settlement in the Las Vegas Valley. They departed Salt Lake City on April 10th, taking only what they could raise to survive on. Their intention was to raise crops in the warmer southern climate, which was more conducive to farming as opposed to the colder northern climate of the Salt Lake area. The journey took approximately 30 days, and they arrived on June 14, 1855. Soon after, the group leader, William Bringhurst, chose the spot for the fort about 4 miles from the Las Vegas Springs and next to the Las Vegas Creek, which allowed the construction of a mill, an essential part of the fledgling settlement. Soon, adobe walls, which were 2 feet thick at the base and tapering to a foot at the top, complete with gun ports for defense, as well as a bastion allowing for 360-degree observation of the surrounding area, were constructed. The structure was typical of forts built at the time and designed to protect the mission from exterior hostile threats. Well, hey, this gate looks just like the one in the snow globe in the game.
That's right. This is the gate to the old Las Vegas Mormon Fort. There were 2 gates, one here and one over there. And so, yes, there were 2 gates originally in the actual fort. We know this because the Mormon journals that they wrote tell us.
So that side of the fort, that's gone now. Did it fall down or was it taken down?
This is a reconstruction. But we know exactly where it fits because it was excavated in the 1990s and they found the original footprint. And of course that building's wall is original, so we know it was 4 square walls, 2 gates and 2 bastions.
Now this is really fascinating because I always thought this was the original fort. So was the whole fort lost and then rebuilt as a recreation?
Yes, the whole thing disintegrated except for some houses and ranch houses that had been reconstructed using old adobe bricks. But otherwise it had been repurposed and taken away. Except for that, that's original. That wall was never torn down.
I always wondered how this old 19th century fort existed surrounded by all this modern urban sprawl, which is very much how it appears in the game and made it so wonderfully out of place. But wow, it's really here.
Yes, it is really here. Even though this is a reconstruction, it's exactly as it was.
Now this tower over here is really familiar to all the fans of the game.
Yeah. Let's walk over there and take a look. So we're talking about the bastion, or the tower that's in the game. There were 2 bastions, but this is the one that's been reconstructed, and it is 2 stories. So now we're entering our inside the bastion of the old Las Vegas Mormon Fort. And as you look around, you'll see it looks a little different than in the video game. In the video game, you're walking up kind of a enclosed staircase that goes up. But you can see, in fact, this is a little different. There's a floor above us with one ladder. And there is no snow globe up there right now, just so you know.
Okay.
But but this is the bastion, and this is the lookout. And there were 2 of these at the old Las Vegas Mormon Fort.
Over the course of the next 2 years, the old Mormon Fort struggled to survive in the unforgiving Mojave Desert. Leadership disputes and a failed mining venture led to low morale, and about half of the original missionaries returned to Salt Lake. Even though more missionaries arrived shortly after, they faced the same hardships and eventually returned to Salt Lake as well, this time leaving the old fort nearly completely abandoned.
After the Mormon missionaries left, they were only here 2 years, ranchers bought this land, and they bought the water rights. The railroad wanted those water rights in 1902. So the railroad came up, purchased all this land from Helen Stewart, the primary rancher at the time, the largest landowner, and they acquired all this land with all the water rights and they started regulating the water, and that's how they fit in. They then auctioned off little town sites that created Las Vegas.
A few years later, after the Mormons left the old fort, and shortly after the conclusion of the Civil War, ranching became one of the leading industries in the American Southwest, and this gave new purpose to the old Mormon fort. In 1865, rancher Octavius Gass, a former miner, set up operations from the abandoned fort and developed the Las Vegas Ranch. He built a small ranch house in the southwest corner of the yard and began ranching. The ranch was completed in 1873, where Gass lived until 1881. When ownership of the ranch was transferred to Archibald Stewart, who assumed ownership after Gass was unable to repay his loan. Stewart and his wife Helen moved to the ranch in 1882. By 1887, the thriving ranch had nearly doubled in size. In 1888, it became clear that the San Pedro, Los Angeles, and Salt Lake City Railroad, which would later become the Union Pacific Railroad, would be coming through the area. Helen and her father acquired large tracts of land, anticipating the growth boom that would result from the arrival of the railroad. The gambit paid off when Helen sold 1,800-some acres of the water-rich ranch to the railroad in 1902 for $55,000, a considerable sum by today's standards. The railroad boomed, and Las Vegas quickly grew. By 1905, building sites just south of the old fort were being auctioned off, and in no time at all, markets, butcher shops, mercantiles, and hotels were popping up all over. The ranch even hosted an attraction called the Vegas Park Plunge, which was built on the creek and featured a community swimming pool of sorts. And if you ask me, this was the first glimpse of the Vegas lifestyle that was yet to come. The population soared to 1,500, and Las Vegas was on its way to becoming a notable Western city, due in large part to the vision and instincts of Helen Stewart, who became known as the First Lady of Las Vegas. She was known to be a leading authority and keeper of Southern Nevada history and served as a valued member of the Nevada Historical Society and Society of Nevada Pioneers. She was instrumental in improving education for the ever-growing population of children in Las Vegas, as well as that of the children of the Paiute, the people who she had worked closely with on the ranch, earning their respect and friendship. She gifted them with a large parcel of land on which to build a Paiute colony where she established a school. Helen was the first woman elected to the Clark County School Board and was the first woman to sit on a jury in Nevada. Further, she was the first postmaster of Las Vegas, serving from 1893 to 1903. The Old Mormon Fort was indeed the birthplace of Las Vegas, and Octavius Gass is recognized as the father of Las Vegas. But if you ask me, Helen Stewart most certainly is the mother of Las Vegas.
So you're looking over to this area. That's the oldest standing building in the entire state of Nevada.
This one here?
Yeah, this one right here.
Yeah. What was this used for?
This was a fort. If you look at this whole area, the wall in here, there are original bricks from 1855. This is part of the 1855 fort. So this was sort of a fortress. But it's also where all the Mormon missionaries lived. So they built this so they could live. But 2 years later, they left. And after that, people used it for sort of thing, ranch houses, a blacksmith shop, way stations, you name it. It was used over the decades for sort of things.
In 1929, the Bureau of Reclamation leased one of the original adobe buildings near the creek and inside the area that was the original fort to be converted to a laboratory designed to test concrete for use in the Hoover Dam, one of the most significant building projects in U.S. history and a game changer for building technology and innovation. It's simply amazing that the old fort, one of the very first settlement structures in Las Vegas, played a key role in the advances made that allowed for the construction of the Hoover Dam, arguably the most significant structure to impact the Las Vegas Valley in modern times. As the old Mormon fort gradually disappeared due to the effects of time and aging, the Daughters of the Utah Pioneers came to the rescue in 1944 by starting a preservation project and obtaining a lease from the railroad to establish the fort as a state historic site and museum. The main wall and the iconic bastion have been reconstructed, as well as the corral and the garden area. The site opened to the public in the year 2000. In June of 2005, Nevada State Parks opened the Education Facility and Interpretive Center, which wonderfully preserves and presents the dynamic history of the old Mormon fort with amazing displays, exhibits, and educational materials and programs covering the indigenous cultural history and all that has happened since. In the Black History exhibit, you can learn about Park Ranger Ray Richardson, the first Black Nevada State Parks Ranger and one of the longest serving rangers in the state. The visitor center is complete with meeting rooms for educational seminars and even has a small theater where you can watch videos presenting the amazing history of the fort, an excellent way to learn about the fort before you go outside to explore it. And of course, no great park would be complete without a well-stocked gift shop where you can find the perfect souvenir to take home and treasure. The Old Mormon Fort gift shop is full of wonderful keepsakes from all kinds of beautiful native and custom jewelry to wonderful postcards full of images of the fort and the key figures in its history, you'll find a wide selection of books for all ages, ranging from historical works all about the fort, as well as wonderful children's books set in the Southwest. There's also a huge selection of cookbooks catering to pioneer cooking, as well as, jeepers, there's even a cookbook dedicated to our favorite canned meat! And there's certainly all kinds of fun toys. On your way out, be sure to visit the gift shop and take home something to help you cherish the fort forever. So although that concludes our tour of the Old Mormon Fort, which was awesome by the way, I wanted to share one more super cool thing with you. On June 3rd, Sherri in the Old Mormon Fort will be hosting a Fallout New Vegas snow globe making class where you can make your own Mormon Fort snow globe just like the one in the game right here at the very fort itself. How cool is that? The class is open to anyone 13 years or older and only costs the park admission of $3 plus a $5 donation to the fort's volunteer organization, Friends of the Fort. The price includes the snow globe materials. Space is limited, so reserve your place today by calling 702-486-3511. That's 702-486-3511. Though the original mission of the Old Mormon Fort, envisioned by Brigham Young, only lasted a brief couple years, the legacy of the fort and its impact on what would become the dynamic and one-of-a-kind western city that is Las Vegas is undeniable, and the fort's recognition as the birthplace of Las Vegas is well-earned. So there you have it, folks! The Old Mormon Fort, one of the most iconic New Vegas locations you can visit right here today. Coyote? Coyote? Where's my car? Oh no.
Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas! Viva Las Vegas!